Let's learn IIB. Today we will talk about SOAP message validations in IIB integration service. I have created many integration services and they are available to you on GitHub. Link in description. Here is an interview question for you. What happens when you pass an additional field not part of WSDL to a SOAP service? Can you pass additional metadata values in SOAP operation? You would have seen many kinds of errors when you invoke a SOAP service. Some business errors such as invoice number not found in backend system. Technical errors such as 401 authorization failed, so on. Today, we will talk about message model validation errors from SOAP integration service. Notice that the input string, the field, has to occur only once in SOAP message and only once. Let's test different scenarios of that use case. We first send one input string and expect a positive reply. This SOAP operation accepts a string input and finds the email address in the input string. It replies with the email address it found. When you send two input string fields, SOAP operation replies with a schema validation error. It tells you that no child element is expected on line number 6, column number 23. That is the second occurrence of input string field. In the next test, we send an additional field and we get validation error. It tells us the name of the additional field. If I have to create a complex data type that checks for required fields and ignores additional fields, how would I do that? Let me know your suggestions in comment section.